Hey everybody, stay tuned where Rob and I will be talking about cost management in a governance way. Welcome to the Azure Enablement Show, where we're having conversations with Microsoft experts around some of the technical obstacles or questions you might have along your cloud adoption journey. Now, we're talking about governance today, and we're talking about the cost discipline within governance. And to take me through that conversation is Rob. Rob, welcome back to the show.
Oh, hey, Sarah. Thank you for having me again.
It's awesome to see you. Now, cost management is probably something we've all had to do a little bit at home to manage some of our budgets. But why is it so important when we're talking about the cloud, Rob?
Well, cost management is one of the biggest concerns our customers have when they talk about governance. In fact, I would usually tell people when they start getting into doing governance work and understanding what this is, cost is probably one of the leading areas where they're going to want to get into. It could be because they had an unexpected bill, they don't understand their forecast or their budgets. There's a lot of reasons for why cost is such an important thing. The Cloud Adoption Framework, of course, covers this in great deal. Detail underneath the governance methodology. In fact, if you look at my screen here, you'll see that we have five disciplines that are outlined in the govern methodology for the Cloud Adoption Framework. I've highlighted cost here because that's the one that we're going to be talking about today.
Awesome. When we're thinking about cost management, whose role is it to look after cost management? Is it the IT department? Is it a single workload team? Should it be the finance department within the organization? Who actually takes care of this now, Rob?
So the way we usually define this or answer this is it's a team sport. I absolutely expect to see not only somebody maybe as high up as like the CFO of the company, but also the line of business application owners, the developers, of course, your central IT department. They're going to have a piece to play in this, and they all need to come together, define what are the business risks. What policy should we put into place? Where do we need to have compliance? And then what are the processes that we need to wrap around this? And of course, we provide a lot of tools out of the box to help you do this with the with cost management specifically.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense, and hopefully it takes the burden off the IT department. However, if one of these people looking after cost management is tasked with actually taking action, maybe saving some money, Rob, what are the best things that they should be having a look at doing?
Oh, absolutely. So first off, we provide some native tools for them. So they're like, oh my gosh, how do I understand my costs? I have many subscriptions. I have a lot of different resource groups. I have tagged a bunch of my different applications and things like that. And how do I really get a handle out of this, right? And how do I govern this at scale? So we put some native tools in place for them. And I actually highlighted them on the screen here for you, Sarah, where we could use a combination of ARM templates, Azure blueprints, definitely using Azure Policy. We have Azure Cost Management and Advisor. All these tools can be utilized to help you put the guardrails in place and to help you understand where your costs are coming from and putting rules and alerts in place. I know it's nice to highlight them here, but I could actually show you a few of these if you'd like to see them.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Oh, awesome. Let's take a look here. Okay. First off, if you're just looking to get started, I do have us opened up into our Cloud Adoption Framework. We're in the govern methodology, and there is a nice overview of the cost management discipline. I'm going to show you a couple different tools right now, Sarah, but it's really important for you to notice that we do have a link here in the CAF, in the Cloud Adoption Framework, for Azure tools for cost management. So you'll find some of these tools that I'll highlight today, so you don't have to memorize everything as we go through them. So I'll ask folks that want to get started with this, go into Azure's, go log into the portal and go to Azure Cost Management. And in here, we have a couple different views that you should be looking at. The first one is the cost analysis view. Now, in this particular view, I've got this broken out to daily cost And I've actually selected my calendar by this quarter. And what's really nice about this is because I've selected quarter, I'm going to get a forecast. So not only my actual cost, but what's my forecast going to be over the rest of the quarter? And that's really interesting because it's going to tell me, am I on track or not? And I can actually see this dotted line here. That's my budget that I've set. And I'll show you in a minute where I've got that configured. But I could definitely see that I'm trending to being over budget by, you know, about $115 a day. Now, this view here is pretty handy, but you could do some additional filtering as well. I've got this right now grouped by resource group name and daily, and I've got this in a stacked column. But I actually could go in here and even carve this up a little bit more granular if I'd like. See how we support tags? And I can click on tags here. And I've got a bunch of different tags in this particular resource group, but cost center may be one that's pretty interesting for a cost management, you know, scenario like this. So now I've split this up into my cost centers, and you could see that I have three cost centers carved out. You could see them by the numbers there. And now I can see, well, all right, here's my budget by cost center, you know, by day. And that's a really nice way to kind of slice into the data. So, and I'll actually touch on how we can actually put policy in place to help us do that tagging in just a moment. Okay. The next thing to look at is alerts. So, hey, that's really great, but we can't imagine people like to be constantly going in there, right, and looking at it. That's crazy. No one's got the time for that. So let's get some alerts configured here. So next thing I would ask people to do is once you've kind of done some cost analysis, go into cost alerts and create some alerts based on your budgets that you've set. And so that way you're notified when you're maybe at 50% of your budget or getting close to maybe 80% of your budget. So that way you're aware of what's happening and you could maybe course correct.
Yeah, that sounds amazing. So the alerts, Rob, are an email form that can maybe go out to a distribution list or even log tickets on your service desk tool so that the processes can be kicked off. Is that right?
Yeah, I believe when you set up the alerts, it'll send it to whoever is the owner of the subscription is one way you can configure it so you don't have to keep coming in and maintaining a list of email addresses when it sends out the alerts. But you can also set it up to be, like you said, a distribution list or something like that. Cool. Just whatever works for your organization. Go ahead.
Sorry, you said policy can help with the tagging. Do you have a wee demo to show us there as well, Rob?
Oh, absolutely. So as you can imagine, to manually go in or write PowerShell commands to go in and do the tagging for you, that's a lot to take on. So what we've done is we've put some policies in out of the box for you where you could utilize these policies to simply do some of the tagging for you. And what I've done here is I've gone over to the Azure portal under policy, and I've filtered this to a subscription where I've got some tags that I've already set up. But let's just pick on the one here that's called append cost center tag to resource group. This is a very common one that I think a lot of our listeners today would be very interested in. So if I go ahead and look up this one that I have set up here, let me just drill into it for a second. You can see that I've got this set up and I can see which of my resource groups are not compliant. I can, of course, change the filter here to see which ones are compliant. And that'll say, all right, so these have the following tags in it for cost center. Fantastic. And if I want to go ahead and, you know, do another assignment or edit this assignment, I can actually go in here first and say, let's view the definition of the policy. It's I promise you, it's not a complex one. It's built in, so you don't have to maintain any of the code. So we could go in here and take a look at it. It's simply going to ask for what's the name of the tag that you want to use. An example would be environment, cost center, application owner, right? You could use that many different ones. And then the value would be, well, what value do you want to add in there for that? So if it was environment, production makes sense, or maybe you would have staging or test. If it was cost center, you may say, well, all right, I'm going to append the, I don't know, 0015, whatever my cost center happens to be. So I could go in here, click assign, pick my scope. So this would be like, what subscription would I want or resource group would I want to be tagging? I can give it a name, so I don't have to leave the default name. But when I go next here, I can simply here just call it, like I said, like cost center. And of course, what value did I want to put on that particular resource group? And I don't know, I could 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just for the demo here. And when I'm done with this, I would just, you know, go next through, and then it would go ahead and be deployed on whatever scope I picked. So from a scope perspective, maybe I selected a subscription and then a resource group in here. You know, so here I'll pick my subscription to keep it simple, just so you could all see it. There's my subscription, and here's a resource group. I'll pick, I don't know, that one there. And I would say select there. And so when I went and, you know, went through this, that was would be where it would be assigned.
Awesome. That's really useful, that policy, if people forget to actually append the tags when they're deploying the resources. Now, I think you mentioned that Azure Advisor is also a great tool for cost management. And I'm going to be dead cheeky here, Rob, and say, do you have a demo for that as well to show us how it can help?
Oh, absolutely, Sarah. So, of course, you've got your budget set here, right? And you're looking at it and you're saying, okay, well, my budget is set at this amount. I could just look based on the analysis that I am on track to be over budget. So what can I do about it? Azure Advisor is just a fantastic tool to go in and take a look. So if I go into Advisor here, you could see that we've got this broken down in a couple different areas. But the one that I'm most interested in today with you is around cost. So if we drill into cost, it's going to say, hey, these are some areas where you can improve your costs and maybe find some savings. Now, some of them may be around, you know, maybe purchasing reserve instances, right? And that's one way to save on cost. Another one could be as simple as right-sizing or shutting down underutilized VMs. And in fact, this one's really cool because it has a quick fix. So if I drill into here, it's going to tell me which machines are underutilized, and you know there's a good amount of potential savings here, so I can select them. And then once I've got them, do you see right up here where it says quick fix preview? This is something new that we've added into Azure Advisor. But by clicking this, it will actually walk us through giving us a recommendation for resizing them and helping us to resize them. So it's a very handy way to go about doing this without you having to write, again, a lot of PowerShell scripts or custom codes. We're trying to put all the tools in your hand and make this as simple as possible so you can implement some of these, utilize some of these cost tools and follow along in the cloud adoption framework.
Awesome. Azure Advisor is definitely something I need to have a look at once I come off this call with you, Rob, and check if there's any cost savings I can do on my subscription as well. Now, I know from previous conversations that you speak quite a bit to customers, and I always like hearing if there's any stories that you can share about some of the mistakes maybe other customers have made that could help educate us to maybe not do those mistakes again elsewhere. Do you have any wee tidbits that you could share with us today, Rob?
Well, I mean, I definitely talk to a lot of customers. And as I said, with the cloud adoption framework, cost is usually the number one thing that they come into and say, hey, we need to learn how to do govern, right? Governance is very important to us. We are having some unexpected, like I said, costs, or we're seeing some behaviors that we're really going to try to correct or to work on. And I definitely see customers making, different mistakes and things like that, as you said. And there's always some interesting ones that are out there. But one of the ones that comes top to mind is, around just putting the proper governance in around cost is, you know, if you say you have a subscription, you're working with an application team, this is a real customer scenario here. Or a real customer story, but you know, their developers are writing some amazing code, right? And they're working on their applications, and they're going really great. And you know, the developers say they haven't really been governed, right? They haven't gone through the cost management discipline. And what can sometimes happen there is developers are going to pick, the size VMs that are going to make their code run the best, right? And they may just say, hey, I'm just going to pick the biggest VMs that are VM series that I have available to me. And so my code runs just amazing, right? But they may also find that they're really over budget, and we see some unexpected costs, especially if you have more of a centralized IT model where, you know, the costs are all coming back down to just one central, you know, cost center. And they're like, oh my gosh, where are all these costs? And they sit down with the developers like, yeah, I picked this one because it had 16, you know, CPUs and it was like just blazing fast. And those types of things happen. And that's why we really encourage folks to go through, look at the cost management discipline in the cloud adoption framework and put the guardrails in place to bring these things in and keep things under control.
Awesome. I think probably we're all a little bit guilty of giving our VMs just that wee bit more juice than they need. So it's definitely an important one to remember.
Now, yeah, absolutely. There's a couple other best practices too to share with you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, there's a few others. The other one I would just highlight for us and the group here is just when you're going and thinking about cost management, it is really important, of course, to get the hierarchy for how you're going to structure your environment. So that's definitely a best practice. So work with your group to define that hierarchy. Definitely look at budgets and alerts, right? We have found that to be a very important way to keep things under control. Some of the policies that I just shared with you a few minutes ago around tagging, the story I told you about the customer VM SKUs, those are some great default policies that we have in there that you can utilize. And of course, let's define our roles and responsibilities for the cost, right? Who's in charge or who's responsible for the various pieces of the application so that we have a clear knowledge of who's accountable, who's responsible, right? Who's contributing and who just needs to be informed. So all these things are just really important that they come in. These are great best practices that I would encourage everybody on the call to think through when they go through the cloud adoption framework's govern cost discipline.
Awesome. Thank you so much for guiding me through this cost management journey, Rob. I have a clear picture in my head about what I should be thinking about. Now, if you want to check out some of the resources or any of the tools that Rob mentioned during the episode, please do check our description box where we'll be dropping the links to that. And remember to tune in to future Azure Enablement Show episodes as well.